terrorist financing and funding. So as far as that aspect is concerned, we have succeeded, one, in identifying those that are responsible for funding, two, blocking the leakages associated with funding, and then three, embarking on aggressive investigation that is indeed impacting positively in terms of the fight against terrorism. So, but then, the truth of the matter is that investigation is ongoing, is advancing, and for the purpose of investigation, I would like to be preemptive in terms of making disclosures that will have the effect of undermining the successes we are recording as far as investigation is concerned. But one thing I can tell you for sure, that whatever we do in terms of detention, in terms of arrest, is indeed backed by judicial process. We have indeed obtained legitimate court orders taking into consideration what we have presented before the court. The court eventually exercised its discretion in terms of granting orders that we can have them in custody pending the conclusion of investigation, which investigation in essence is indeed deeply taking place, and we are making a lot of successes and recording a lot of progress in the direction of it. Intend to attend in Washington D.C. by tomorrow is concerned. We are looking at the possibility of recording further £200 million, among others. But then that does not mean to say that there are no other associated assets being pursued in the international. In terms of some other countries of the world, inclusive of Ireland and some other countries, we are pursuing a lot of assets across the globe. And we intend very soon to we are coordinating a further meeting relating to each recovery in UK associated with certain personalities. But then I would like to give further disclosure and respect there to taking into consideration the need not to be preemptive as far as our strategies are concerned.